I'm glad you guys are drinking it up. It's good. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Be careful with that. I don't want to get preachy early in the show. I don't want to get heavy on you guys, but be careful. Make sure you got a driver, because you know what? You have too much to drink, and you drive home, you could kill somebody. It happened. You could kill somebody. Or worse, you could get a DUI. And that's the way I wanted to say that. That's the way... Because you know what? Because DUIs, people don't want to talk about this, but DUIs are always bad. Every single time, bad. Not every person hit by a drunk driver was a good person. That's just numbers. That's statistics. You know? Like, if you get hammered tonight and you drive home and you run down a pedophile, should you go to prison? Should you? Or should you be given a high five parade, a trophy, and a medal? Should say hero on it, if that's what you are. Seriously though, really be careful. The worst experience in my adult life, I got a DUI, one of the worst, a DUI a couple years ago. Basically, in Santa Monica 2 years ago, I learned one night it was a lot harder than I thought to take a 90-degree turn into my own parking garage at 3 o'clock in the morning at about 50 miles an hour. And it boiled down to a parking disagreement. I felt at the time that I had parked in front of the meter. The police officer felt I had parked through that meter into a tree. And he was 100% correct. And he chose to blame alcohol, even though to this day, I choose to blame Super Mario Kart for giving me a little too much confidence and my ability to turn sharply under any condition. I had played like 2 straight days of Super Mario Kart on the Wii. I'm good at Super Mario Kart, you guys. And that was my last like coherent thought. I'm like, you know what? Let's finish this night in style, Cummins. Let's power slide this bitch. I mean, you do it on the mushroom cup like 100 times a day. How hard can it be in a Jetta? Pretty goddamn hard, actually. No A button, for starters. That makes it almost impossible. And I got in a lot of trouble, as I should have. I had to go to jail for the night. You know, like 3 months of classes, you know, lots of fines, you know, and I should have gotten in trouble. But the worst part, first time DUI in LA County, you can get an interlock ignition device installed in your car. So I had a breathalyzer thing in my car for 6 months. A lot of fun, you guys. A lot of fun. In my mind, I'd never seen one, and I thought you'd have to blow like this to start. I'd be like, whew. Like you were just trying to get a sweet butterfly off of your steering wheel. Just like, go on, go home. And then your car would just start up. No, you have to donate lung tissue. Like, I would have to sustained heavy breath to the point of seeing spots every time to start my car to maybe make it work. To finally just unreal. Just unreal. And just like, whoo! And then doo-doo-doo. That's the tone that was set for every trip for half a year. Just, all right, everybody buckled up? All right, we all good? We all ready to go to Disneyland? Okay. Whoo! Whoo! Number one dad. Where's my sweater? Oh. And they put it in as a safety device, but it's the most unsafe thing I've ever had in my car. Because I get having to do something crazy like that to start your car. That's fine. But you also have to do that 5 minutes into your drive while driving. And then every 30 minutes, the whole trip, unless you want your hazards to flash and your horn to go on and off and your lights to blink until the police take you to jail. I am not advocating drinking and driving. Truly, I am not. But I am a better drunk driver than I am going 70 miles an hour down the freeway in heavy traffic and for 30 seconds have to take my eyes completely off the road to deep throat my Hyundai. Not safe. Not my eye, Hyundai. Yeah, that's awful. But drink up is what I'm trying to tell you guys. Yeah, enjoy.